Greetings, this is the Get To Free Press, and I'm George Boston Rhines out of Valdosta, Georgia. I had an individual to call me that resides in Atlanta, Georgia. Clark Howard, he has called local news media here in Atlanta.
City of Atlanta, Public Works, 11th and North Avenue, for 10 years, from 1988 to 1990.
Why did you call me here to cover this story?
I have been trying to get my pictures since April the 10th.
Have you gone to the Atlanta Journal and Constitution or Clark Howard or anybody else in Atlanta, WAOK radio station, anybody to get your story told? Because there just may be other former employees for the city of Atlanta that still haven't received their money that they have rightfully earned, but it seems as if those black city government will not pay y'all. So you think there may be others in this same predicament?
I question you in.
City Hall in Atlanta. We are headed to the mayor's office.
I have a meeting for you in the mayor's office. Recently, in the last month, we sent the mayor a certified letter about my issue. So you don't want to see it.
A fine. On the application, you had to send a copy of my birth certificate to the mayor. But when I never received
June 1st. Wait 15 days for a response. We didn't get a response. We called back. The lady that we talked to on the phone was the lady that received the certified letter. And she indicated, well, sir, send me another copy. Ma'am, in every department of the city of Atlanta, from the pension department, the law office.
So you don't have another copy?
Everybody has a copy. What's the purpose? Keep
so
seeing your copy.
Is it possible if we can get another? Because we get the mayor a copy.
Listen to me. Everybody down here.
I waited, we're doing the budget. I waited 4 months to get an appointment.
Yeah. I went to the pension board office, talked to Ray Adams. They sent me to the law office. Then when we went to the law office, he sent it back down to the picture. He just,
what do you think about interweek? You believe that?
No, I don't.
What does this respond?
I can't tell you what the response is going to be.
Well, I need the paper trail where I sign the check. See, I've been through this before you.
I know. I realize that.
So my request and your response, will it show a paper trail where I sign the check?
Okay, after doing that walk, what do you think? Are you feeling more confident, or how do you feel about your situation now?
Well, sir, I feel confident.
I
when
can't
they give me my money.
Say what?
I don't know what. All I can say is that they're sticking together. They're sticking together. The resources that the city of Atlanta have, if I had a way to Jamaica, Russia, they have the resources to find out where the money was. The SEC, the Securities Exchange Commission office out of Washington, D.C., allegedly said that even she said that was in 2013, that the pension director in Belgium, $1.2 million.
What's your name and a phone number?
James Rutledge. Phone number 678-760-0725.
Thank you very much. It's a great possibility that maybe some news media here in Atlanta will care enough about your situation to focus in on it. I'm down in Valdosta. I don't mind putting it out there. But I believe that there should be Atlanta Journal-Constitution. Somebody should address your issues. Because after all, there may be a lot of other people with the same problems, but they just gave up because nobody would cover their story.
Well, P.S., they responded. I did get in contact with Claude Howard 2 years ago.
Okay.
One of his assistants said that if the two or three people that they can't involve with just my single issue.
Yes, sir.
But if it's three or four different people having the same problem that I'm having, then it's a problem.
Okay. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Have you gone to the Atlanta Journal and Constitution or Clark Howard or anybody else in Atlanta, WAOK radio station, anybody to get your story told? Because there just may be other former employees for the city of Atlanta that still haven't received their money that they have rightfully earned. But it seems that this though black city government will not pay y'all. So you think there may be others in the same predicament?
Thank you.
deadline to get my pictures is April the 10th.
Have you gone to the Atlanta Journal and Constitution or Clark Howard or anybody else in Atlanta, WAOK radio station, anybody to get your story told? Because there just may be other former employees for the city of Atlanta that still haven't received their money that they have rightfully earned. But it seems as if those black city government will not pay y'all. So you think there may be others in the same predicament? To cover this story.
I have been trying to get my pictures since April the 10th.
Have you gone to the Atlanta Journal and Constitution or Clark Howard or anybody else in Atlanta, WAOK radio station, anybody to get your story told? Because there just may be other former employees for the city of Atlanta that still haven't received their money that they have rightfully earned, but it seems as if those black city government will not pay y'all. So you think there may be others in the same predicament?
You in.
City Hall in Atlanta. You're headed to the mayor's office.
Recently, in the last month, we sent the mayor office certified that so you don't want to see a fine. On the application, you had to send a copy of my birth certificate. Allegedly, I never received
June 1st. Wait 15 days for a response. We didn't get a response. We called back. The lady that we talked to on the phone was the lady that received the certified mail. And she indicated, well, sir, send me another copy. Ma'am, in every department of the city of Atlanta, from the pension department, the law office.
So you don't have another copy?
Everybody has a copy. What's the purpose? Keep seeing your copy.
Is it possible if we can get another? Because we get the mayor a copy.
Listen to me.
Everybody down here.
We're doing the budget. I waited 4 months to get an appointment. I went to the pension board office, talked to Ray Adams. They sent me to the law office. Then when we went to the law office, he sent me back down to the pension.
What do you think about Anna Wick? Do you believe that?
No, I don't.
What does
this respond?
I can't tell you what the response is going
to
be.
Well, I need the paper trail where I sign the check. See, I've been through this before here.
I know. I realize that.
So my request and your response, will it show a paper trail where I sign the check?
So you think there may be others in the same predicament?
Where you in?
City Hall in Atlanta. headed to the mayor's office.
Pension department, the law office.
So you don't have another copy?
Everybody has a copy. What's the purpose? Keep saying your copy.
Is it possible if we can get another? Because we get the mayor a copy.
Listen. Just listen to me.
Everybody down here. I waited, we're doing the budget. I waited 4 months to get an appointment. Yeah. I went to the pension board office, talked to Ray Adams. They sent me to the law office. Then when we went to the law office, he sent me back down to the picture. He just
what do you think about Ellen Wick? You believe that?
No, I don't. What the do?
Thank you.
Yes, sir.
But if it's three or four different people having the same problem that I'm having, then it's a problem.
Okay. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Weaver. She handles the
June 1st, wait 15 days for a response. We didn't get a response, so we called back. The lady that we talked to on the phone was the lady that received the certified mail. Mm-hmm. And she indicated, well, sir, send me another copy. Ma'am, in every department of the city of Atlanta, from the pension department, the law office.
So you don't have another copy?
Everybody has a copy. What's the purpose? Keep seeing your copy.
Is it possible if we can get another? Because we get the mayor a copy.
Listen to me.
Everybody down here has a copy.
Okay, sir. I don't have a copy.
In 4 years.
I don't have a copy, sir. That's why I'm asking. If you don't want to give me one, that's okay, sir. That's all I'm asking.
Excuse me, man. What if he just give you? Can you make a copy of it?
Yes. Can you do that? I have no problem making a copy for you. She's the COO. I'm the scheduling assistant for Mayor Reed.
We got you. If I can get a copy, I definitely don't.
When she comes back with it, ma'am, you're more than
that. No problem. Okay.
But see, the reason that I think they just sent me through the waiting stage all over again. I've been at this for 4 years. Mm-hmm. 4 years. I waited when the commissioner was doing the budget. I waited 4 months to get an appointment.
Okay.
I went to the pension board office, talked to Ray Adams. They sent me to the law office. Okay. Then when I went to the law office, he sent me back down to the pension. Well, it just been in and out of one place to another.
Well, to make something real short, from my understanding, he called me. I'll come up in Valdosta. But if he requested, if he just could see, don't worry about that. If he could just see the back of the checks where he signed, it won't.
Then the paper trail away with the bank.
But he can't. His signature not even on the checks they sent. I don't know why they would even send him a copy of a check.
You mean with the pension people, right?
Well,
but
the checks that he supposedly cashed.
Uh-huh.
His signature.
When I apply, just the application of applying for the money, I have to send them a copy of my birth certificate to apply for the money. They wanted to make sure that I was who I said I was.
Okay.
But yet, when they gave me a check of $8,000, allegedly, it should be a copy of a valid picture ID to receive the money.
Gotcha.
If it's that strict on the application, why is it so lack on the receiver? They have not gave me my money.
Well, let me go check back with Camille since she has it.
I'm not asking for no food stamp welfare. This is.
I think you're going to need to. Is this copy for us or do
you need to make
back?
A copy, though. That's my own personal.
Okay, so we'll make a copy of this and we'll respond to you in writing by the end of the week. Okay?
Okay.
Okay.
What do you think about the end of the week? You believe that?
No, I don't.
You don't.
No, I don't.
Why don't you believe they're gonna respond to you? This is city government.
They haven't responded in 4 years. Why am I saying that they're gonna respond in the end of the week? Okay. And when she get back, then they'll respond. I want a paper trail of the signature, my signature, and the paper trail that it went to a bank. And I'm going to ask her that when she come back. Which your response include all the information. And I'm going to get a video. I want to speak to the mayor for senior reading. What does the this response?
I can't tell you what the response is gonna be.
Well, I need the paper trail where I sign the check. See, I've been through this before.
I know. I realize that.
So my request and your response, will it show a paper trail where I sign the check?
I can't say that it will have the signed check. I see that they provided you a copy of this check. I don't know that they'll be able to provide the back side of this check because this was from.
Well, see, I asked for this.
This was, I realized what
in you, 97 and 98.
Yeah, this was from 1997. I don't know if they'll be able to provide that for you. I don't. I can't.
They will. So what is your response? I mean, I've been through this. That's why I am requesting.
Right.
I requested this 3.5 years ago.
I see that you have met with HR. We will review this information and you will receive a response. I can't tell you what it's going to be. I haven't read any of the information you provided.
And your response.
I'm sorry?
In all that you're doing now.
Uh-huh.
I'm requesting that I can speak to American Senior Reed.
Okay. They'll respond and let you know whether or not you can have an appointment.
No, it's not an option.
Okay.
This is money that I work for.
Okay.
They have not gave me one dime. Not a dime.
Okay.
You say you gave me a check, but it's no signature, it's no paper trail. With all the resources that the city of Atlanta, even in 1998, have, in 4 years, they could have went to Africa and investigated, find out what happened to my money. In 4 years, with all the resources that the city of Atlanta have, in 4 years, if it was embedded over in Africa, they don't have time. My nephew, I have gave him power of attorney to pursue this matter if something ever happened to me. Somebody in my family or me is going to enjoy my pension money. My money that I work for.
Okay.
And everybody tell me to be patient. Like, say, now wait a minute. Then I don't hear no response from you. I don't believe it's going to be a response. Okay, I talked to Councilman Martin. He said, in 4 years, right here, you got a lawyer. I live off a fixed income. I don't have $2,500 to give a lawyer for a retainer fee. That's 3 months of my Social Security check. I don't have that kind of money. And I shouldn't even have to go through this to get my money. Simple. It's just simple, ABC.
You know, another thing, he called me up here. I was up here 3 weeks ago. I came up here from Valor 3 weeks ago. And we talked to a lady that said she was the secretary of the mayor. And we haven't even seen a courteous reply from a city government in the state of Georgia and in the U.S.
Do you know who you spoke to?
Yeah, we have a document. We definitely have it. We document everything.
Do you just have the person's name?
Well, did you write it down there, or did we put it in that tablet?
I think so. It's in this information on the first page, the lady that received the certified letter. I hope y'all don't have to go through what I'm going through.
Receive the certified letter from the mayor? Pardon
me?
Receive this letter from the mayor?
Yeah.
That was me.
Oh, okay. But then you asked me to send another copy.
Right, and I never received another
but
copy.
But see, I mean, what's...
And you, a whole month I didn't get a copy from you, sir. If I
a whole month? I've been waiting for 4 years. Every department, I sent you a copy.
I'm sorry. And,
you was the one that told me that you received a copy.
On June 2nd, correct, sir.
So why you need another copy when you already got
the mayor got the copy, the original. I didn't make a copy for myself.
Make five.
I have a copy now, sir.
We have
the copies. We are going to review what you've submitted, and you will have a response from our office within the week, and a response to your request for a meeting with the mayor. Okay.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you, God bless.
Okay. Thank you all very much.
I apologize.
It's okay.
But you don't know how frustrated I am. 4 years.
I understand.
I couldn't even apply for the money in 98. You have to be 55. Even the lawyer from the pension board told me, sir, I don't see how they sent you a check in 98. Even if I had applied in 98, I would have been denied based on the age requirement.
Okay.
You have to be 55. I was 45. I simply changed job. I got a better job at the DeKalb County Sheriff Department, and I changed job. That's all I did.
Well, you'll have a response.
Okay.
Thank you,
God bless.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Thank you for your professionalism. Thank you so much, man. Really do. Thank you.
Where can people, you get a check for
after doing that walk, what do you think? Do you feel any more confident, or how do you feel about your situation now?
Well, sir, I feel confident when they give me my money. Because really, for me, I've been through this for 4 years. I was excited 3 years ago when I talked to the Commissioner Yancey about my case. But being excited and not getting no money, so I'm not excited. I'd be excited when they give me my money.
Do you feel like when she said that you'll get a response, you think that'd just be a general response, but you won't get
it? It's just gonna be a general response. That's why I specified what I want in your response for the paper trail, the signature of the check that I received. Because see, to me, it's just like, here we go again, here we go again.
So being a government entity, you believe that if they actually provided you with a check, that there should be a paper trail somewhere to show that you actually signed for that check, and you know for a fact that you did not sign for the check. Am I correct?
I never see it.
Okay.
I never see it.
Why do you think it's so hard for, from looking at the employees, it seems as if though they seem a little concerned about whether you actually signed for the check or not?
Well, I cannot read and say why a person doing this.
Right. I noticed you're very cautious on that.
I can't say why. No. I don't know why. All I can say is that they're sticking together. They're sticking together. From the law department, the pension department, the Commissioner Yancey department. Everybody is saying that they believe my story. Like, that's the impression that I got from them. They believe my story. But then investigate and find out what happened to my money. With the resources that the city of Atlanta has, if I had a went to Jamaica, Russia, they have the resources to find out where the money was.
And you brought up also, I think you showed some type of documentation that there was something that has been reported in terms of money being misappropriated.
Yes, the SEC, the Securities Exchange Commission Office out of Washington, D.C., allegedly said that even she said that was in 2013, that the pension director in Belgium, $1.2 million. See,
from me doing this since 1975 in terms of on social media, it seems to me that there should be somebody or some agency that can actually account for the taxpayers' dollars, as well as other complaints that may have been registered with the city of Atlanta about other people, workers, not getting their pension.
If the allegedly part was the $1.2 million, there has to be a bunch. That's a lot of money.
Well, a lot of people probably gave up. Why haven't you given up?
Because I'm not asking for a handout. I'm not asking for a handout.
Okay.
I'm asking for the money that I labeled for 10 years. No, it's not ours.
Okay. All right. Thank you very much. One closing remark I'd like to get from you. Why did you call to get to Free Press to get this in the news?
Because I've been going through a revolving door from one department to the other department. Wait 3 months and no response. Then it's starting all over. It's been 4 years. My intention is if the media get involved, then I get some type of result.
Well, we are going to, I do have some contact with some people in Washington, D.C. I doubt they will be able to help, but we will be sending it to some agency that I've sent other stuff, information and videos to, okay?
This step that we're doing now is more encouraging than anything, because I feel like if the media get involved, then they have to respond.
No, they do not.
But it often works better than not having it, but I have worked
cases with Equipment 10 plus 2 with the newly elected black mayors in 16, 18 cities, voting rights, and even the Democratic chair of DeBose Porter won't even address it. Nor the Secretary of State, the Attorney General Sam Olin, they're all aware of this, but they sit back and say and do nothing. So we are hoping that under our form of government that somebody will deal with you, because in your situation you're talking about $14,000 during these hard economic times.
This I just started drawing my Social Security. This money will help me get me a place to stay. I stay with someone. I don't have my own place. You know, the government, you can't live off of $844. You can't. This money would help me achieve that goal.
Okay, once again, what's your name and a phone number?
James Rutledge. Phone number 678-760-0725.
Thank you very much. There's a great possibility that maybe some news media here in Atlanta will care enough about your situation to focus in on it. I'm down in Valdosta. I don't mind putting it out there. But I believe that there should be Atlanta Journal-Constitution. Somebody should address your issues. Because after all, there may be a lot of other people with the same problems, but they just gave up because nobody would cover their story.
Well, P.S., they respond. I did get in contact with Clark Howard 2 years ago.
Okay.
One of his assistants said that if the two or three people that they can't involve with just my single issue.
Yes, sir.
But if it's three or four different people having the same problem that I'm having, then it's a problem.
Okay. Thank you very much. Thank you.
pictures since April the 10th.
Have you gone to the Atlanta Journal and Constitution or Clark Howard or anybody else in Atlanta, WAOK radio station, anybody to get your story told? Because there just may be other former employees for the city of Atlanta that still haven't received their money that they have rightfully earned. But it seems as if those blacks city government will not pay y'all. So you think there may be others in the same predicament?
Question.
What's your name and a phone number?
James Rutledge. Phone number 678-760-0725.
Thank you very much. There's great possibility that maybe some news media here, news media here in Atlanta will care enough about your situation to focus in on it. I'm down in Valdosta. I don't mind putting it out there. But I believe that there should be Atlanta Journal because somebody should address your issues. Because after all, there may be a lot of other people with the same problems, but they just gave up because nobody would cover their story.
Well, P.S., they responded. I did get in contact with Clark Howard 2 years ago.
Okay, okay, okay.
One of his assistants said that if the two or three people that they can't involve with just my single issue.
Yes, sir.
But if it's three or four different people having the same problem that I'm having, then it's a problem.
Okay. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Greetings, this is the Get To Free Press, and I'm George Boston Rhines out of Valdosta, Georgia. I had an individual to call me that resides here. Told me he has been to Clark Howard. He has called local news media here in Atlanta.
City of Atlanta, Public Works, 11th and North Avenue for 10 years, from 1988 to 1990.
Why did you call me here to cover this story?
I have been trying to get my pictures since April the 10th.
Have you gone to the Atlanta Journal and Constitution or Clark Howard or anybody else in Atlanta, WAOK radio station, anybody to get your story told? Because there just may be other former employees for the city of Atlanta that still haven't received their money that they have rightfully earned. But it seems as if those blacks city government will not pay y'all. So you think there may be others in the same predicament?
I question you in.
City Hall in Atlanta. You're headed to mayor's office.
Recently, in the last month, we sent the mayor office certified that no one sees a fine. On the application, they had to send a copy of my birth certificate to the plan. But when I allegedly, I never received
June 30th. Wait 15 days. For response. We didn't get a response. We called back. The lady that we talked to on the phone was the lady that received the certified letter. And she indicated, well, sir, send me another copy. Ma'am, in every department of the city of Atlanta, from the pension department, the law office.
So you don't have another copy?
Everybody has a copy. What's the purpose? Keep seeing your copy.
Is it possible if we can get another? Because we get the mayor a copy.
Listen. Everybody down here.
I waited for the commission. We're doing the budget. I waited 4 months to get an appointment. Yeah. I went to the pension board office, talked to Ray Adams. They sent me to the law office. Then when we went to the law office, he sent me back down to the pension.
Well, just,
What do you think about the end of the week? You believe that?
No, I don't.
What does this respond?
I can't tell you what the response is going
to
be.
Well, I need the paper trail where I sign the check. See, I've been through this before you.
I know. I realize that.
So my request and your response, will it show a paper trail where I sign the check?
Okay, after doing that walk, what do you think? Do you feel any more confident, or how do you feel about your situation now?
Well, sir, I feel confident when they give me my money.
Said what?
Right. I don't know what. All I can say is that they stick in the gift. The resources that the city of Atlanta have, if I had a way to Jamaica, Russia, they have the resources to find out where the money was. The SEC, the Security Exchange Commission office out of Washington, D.C., allegedly said that even she said that was in 2013, that the pension director in Belgium, $1.2 million.
Again, what's your name and a phone number?
James Rutledge. Phone number 678-760-0725.
Thank you very much. It's a great possibility that maybe some news media here, news media here in Atlanta will care enough about your situation to focus in on it. I'm down in Valdosta. I don't mind putting it out there, but I believe that there should be Atlanta Journal-Constitution. Somebody should address your issues, because after all, there may be a lot of other people with the same problems, but they just gave up because nobody would cover their story.
Well,
greetings. This is the Get To Free Press, and I'm George Boston Rhines out of Valdosta, Georgia. I had an individual to call me that resides here in Atlanta, Georgia. And as you know, across the state of Georgia, if not the United States of America, it is hard for Black African Americans to get their story told on mainstream media. I don't care whether it's Atlanta Journal-Constitution, WSB, or other television stations and radio, it is often hard for Black Americans to tell their stories. I'm in Atlanta. I drove up from Valdosta last night because I received a call from an individual that I want you to hear. He has a story to tell. And according to what he has told me, he has been to Clark Howard. He has called local news media here in Atlanta. But I am here to let you know that 3 weeks ago, I called the mayor's office and talked to his secretary. And like this individual, as he will tell you, the mayor, of course, he's Black, he have ignored this individual. We want to record this to let all African Americans and other good, right people in the state of Georgia understand that just electing a Black mayor or a Black city or county commissioner does not mean that you can get your story told. They won't even meet with you. They won't even sit down with you. Secretaries will not even follow up and give you a call back. I did this 3 weeks ago. The mayor nor his secretary has called me back on behalf of this individual. And I'm gonna let him tell you his story. And of course, yes, it is about the money that the city of Atlanta owed this man through his job, through his pension. He worked for the city, but he could not get his money. And so he's going to tell you about it. The only reason that I'm here in Atlanta is because just like when I was in Jacksonville, Port St. Joe, Florida, Savannah, wherever it is, it's always the same. The news media will not report these cutting edge issues. Now, please listen to this young man as he gives his story. And this isn't concerning the city government, not in Afghanistan, Pakistan, Tajikistan, or any of the other states, right here where we stand in the capital of the state of Georgia.
Okay, what's your name?
My name is James Rutledge.
Mr. Rutledge, you called me to cover this story. First of all, where did you work?
I worked for the City of Atlanta Public Works, 11th and North Avenue, for 10 years, from 1988 to 1990.
Why did you call me here to cover this story?
I have been trying to get my picture since April the 10th, 2012. I have talked to Ray Adams, the president of the picture board. I've talked to Commissioner Yancey. I've been to picture board meet. They gave me two checks with the front side. I asked for a paper trail. I asked for the back side. When I applied for my picture, I had to show them a copy of my birth certificate to apply for the money. But yet, when they allegedly gave me the money, I didn't have to give them no ID. I have not received any money from the pension. And I've been waiting 4 years.
How much money are we talking about that the city of Atlanta owe you?
Both checks came to the amount over $9,000 in 1998. But I have requested the return on my investment from 1998 to present.
Okay, so you're saying that although you was entitled to that $9,000, that by now, interest or whatever should have accrued, that you want to collect that too, am I right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now, 3 weeks ago, we called the mayor's office, and the mayor did not respond. Three or four weeks later, the mayor has not responded. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
The clerk that you talked to did not respond. Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
Ago, we called the mayor's office, and the mayor did not respond. Three or four weeks later, the mayor has not responded. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
The clerk that you talked to did not respond. Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
So apparently they have no intentions of paying you. Do you think there may be other blacks who was employed with the city that have not received their pensions either?
The SEC, they investigated this matter, and allegedly the pension director embezzled over $1.2 million from the pension fund.
Now, how can you say they embezzled that much money? What proof do you have? Or is that a figment of your imagination or what?
No, I have the paperwork to back it up from the Securities Exchange Administration.
So why do you think that the current mayor, who's a black American, I believe, why would the mayor not respond to you if it's dealing with your money? You are from the low economic income areas of the city of Valdosta. Why do you think they would not even respond to you or try to give you your money?
I really can't answer that, sir. I don't know why, but I have not received any money. You know, I've tried. They tell me to be patient. I've been patient for 4 years. You know, I would come down. First, I went to the pension board. I talked to Mr. Ray Adams, and he showed me checks where I allegedly got the money. I have not received any money. I went to pension board meet. I talked to the commissioner, Yvonne Yancey, about my money. She even agreed that she believed me, but I haven't received any money.
Now, what you are saying, is this a figment of your imagination, or can you give me some background information about what you actually did, sent certified return receipts, also have pictures of the check, but nothing was shown on the check?
Nothing on the back side, where it went through a bank. The owner showed me the front side. It should be my signature on the back side, just like it took on the application. When I received the check, they allegedly said the freight check for $1,000, they mailed it to me. No, sir, I wouldn't have had you mail me no money. I either would have had a direct deposit and or came by and picked it up. The $8,000 check, they said I came by and picked it up. But it's no paper trail of why I did this. I have never received any money.
And you do have some checks. And what do those checks say to the current black mayor, the current black elected mayor here in Atlanta? What does that say about the mayor, him being African-American? He have heard your story. We called him 3 weeks ago, and yet he ignores you. Why do you think he would do that? It seems like he should feel the pain of what blacks have to go through. How can he sit in office and not say nothing? What's your opinion on that?
I really don't know. This is the first check. Notice this is just the front side.
That's the front side, okay.
I requested 3 years ago for the back side.
Okay.
Where it would show my signature.
Right.
And where it would show that they went to a bank.
Okay.
They can't show me this. They haven't shown me this.
And you have presented this to the city of Atlanta, am I correct?
Yes, sir.
So they are aware that paperwork does not show your signature.
Yes, sir.
Then you turn around and ask them to provide a copy of the same document with your signature, right?
Yes, sir.
And they have not done that.
4 years.
And you contend the reason why they haven't shown it to you because you did not cash your check, am I right?
I have not received any money. I have not received any money.
Okay, now, I've been doing this a long time, so what they will tell you is that you need to get a lawyer. What do you say to that?
I am a senior citizen, sir. I live off a fixed income. The last lawyer that I talked to wanted a $2,500 retainer fee, and I just don't have that type of money. I just don't have, I'm a senior citizen. I live off a fixed income of $844 a month. That's, I don't have money to give a lawyer a $2,500 retainer fee.
Have you gone to the Atlanta Journal and Constitution or Clark Howard or anybody else in Atlanta, WAOK radio station, anybody, to get your story told? Because there just may be other former employees for the city of Atlanta that still haven't received their money that they have rightfully earned, but it seems as if those black city government will not pay y'all. So you think there may be others in this same predicament?
I'm quite sure it is. Allegedly, if $1.2 million was embezzled from the pension director, I think there had to be a couple people. You know what I'm saying? Had to be more than one person. Had to be a bunch of people. And even if the money was stolen, the money is FDIC, it's federally insured. I didn't receive it, so it's up to them.
So, other words, we're dealing with a government entity here. in the city of Atlanta that are dealing with somebody's money
right.
and pension fund,
right.
and they, apparently there is no accountability. So how do you think a city government, a metropolitan city, the capital of the state of Georgia, can take people's money and not even show where they paid the individual? How can they do that?
I can't help it. Why? But I am going to fight this. I have even made arrangement where if I get ill, my nephew, Blair Scott, I have gave him power of attorney to pursue this matter because, no, it's not an option. I'm not asking for a handout. I'm asking for the money that we're doing.
So you're saying you're not asking for no welfare? You're not asking for no side money that you didn't earn? You're asking for the money that you actually earned. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
And yet, no newspaper in Atlanta, no television station in Atlanta, nobody seemed to be interested in you getting this story out to the general public. Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
That is why you called me in Valdosta, Georgia, because you know that I will do what I always do, and that is to report what others ignore.
Yes, sir.
Now, do you mind if I send this to Atlanta Journal and Constitution, WSB, and all other television stations, not only in Georgia, but across the nation? Because people got to understand, even the Department of Justice don't even serve us. We look to the Department of Justice, but we end up just looking.
Yes, sir. I will encourage you. Matter of fact, I insist that you get the media involved. The only way that I'm going to get my money is they're going to have to be pressured. Because I have waited 4 years patiently. I've been to Pigeon Boy and me. I've talked to everybody in City Hall, from Ray Adams to the commissioner, the pitching director, and all of them just turned it back. I haven't got the money. They say they believe my story, but saying it and helping me get my money, it's just like, just talk. It just talk. And even when 3 weeks ago, when I got you involved, and we sent the mayor office a certified letter with a return, the lady on the phone asked me to send some more copies. But she was the one that signed and received the copy. So why should I have to keep sending copies and wait 30 days when every department in the city of Atlanta, from the pension board, from the law office, from the commission office, has a copy, and the mayor office, they have copies. It's just a delay tactic to send more paperwork. But then you have to wait 30 days for them to respond. They haven't responded in 4 years. They have not responded in 4 years.
So is it your belief that they just bent on not paying you? Maybe because you're black, they feel like they can get away with it. But I don't believe it's about skin color. I believe city government just don't want to do what is right. If you produce the checks wherein the check was cash, but you don't have a signature on the check and they provided you with that, I can't even understand why they would even send you the check if it didn't have your signature on it.
Well,
think somebody in city government cashed the check?
I don't know who cashed the check. I don't know who cashed the check. At first, when it first started doing this case, I didn't want to blame them.
Yes, sir.
I didn't want to blame no one particularly. But they are saying that I received money that I never received. See? I didn't receive it, but they telling me that they gave me the money. They did not give it. And they cannot show me a paper trail where I signed it and it went through the bank. But yet, when I applied for the money, I had to send them a birth certificate to apply. But the rules got lax on receiving money. Seemed like to me I would have to show them the same paperwork, the same birth certificate, the same valid driver license to receive a check for $8,000. It's just like, I didn't have to show them no ID. And see, I got a problem with that. Why? Because they know that I never received any money. They know that.
Mr. Rutledge, I want you to understand something from my perspective, and that is, number one, I'm finding out that not only Atlanta,
but many city and county governments will not respond to the citizens in the state of Georgia. They ignore us. We have to fight for everything. And so I want you to know that we have 16 to 18 black mayors in the state of Georgia that are fighting to stay in office because governments, certain elected officials are lying on them, taking them to the Superior Court. Some are being removed from office. And nobody at the state capitol in Georgia legislature or general assembly will even address their issues. So I don't want you to think that you're the only somebody that our elected officials are ignoring. I have documented that this is a pattern and practice that blacks in particular, I can't speak too much about whites, but there are two white mayors that are also catching hell on the backside of heaven. So now, I want you to keep fighting, and I promise you that I will do everything that I can. I told the mayor, secretary, that I will not stop, that I will publish this. I will be sending it to President Barack Obama for all good it will do. I'm going to send it across the nation, because if you was ripped off with the little $14,000 that they may see it, it may be little to them, but I do believe it is great to you. So you have any closing remarks you want to give, or a fact, if you want to give your phone number or email address, where if somebody do see this out there on social media, they will contact you, because we know that mainstream media just not going to do it.
Yes, in conclusion, I'll give my phone number, 678-760-725. No, it's not optional. No, it's not optional. I'm going to receive my money.
One other thing I want to know. Now, some people ask you, why did you wait 4 years to start fighting this struggle? What other paperwork did you send to the city of Atlanta? And if you sent it to them, did you just send it, or did you send it certified return receipt?
Well, the main reason why I applied for it in 2012, April, when I left the city of Atlanta in 98, I wasn't eligible based on their guidelines. You had to be 55 years old. I was 45 in 98. So once I figured out and found out the age limit in 2012, that's when I applied. Even the lawyer, when I went to the pension board speaking with Miss Yancey, said that even if he had applied in 98, he wasn't qualified. I would have been denied. That's why I didn't even apply for it in 98. I simply got a better paying job and went to DeKalb County Sheriff Department. I just changed up. I wasn't eligible to receive a pension at 45. The age limit is 55.
So when they paid that out to somebody, you're saying that you wasn't even eligible then, am I correct?
Yes, sir.
So it shouldn't have been paid out to whoever received the money?
Yes, sir.
Which may lead to, it may have been somebody in the House at City Hall that took the money. I mean, I know you didn't say that. I'm not saying, I said may.
It's a possibility.
I'm using apparently a possibility.
It's a possibility. It's a possibility.
Do you think we can go in and maybe see if the mayor's in?
I would love that.
Let's walk in and see if the mayor's in.
Okay.
City Hall in Atlanta. We are heading to the mayor's office. And he says it's been 4 years that he's been trying to get his pension. The police officer downstairs seemed very concerned and amazed that they had not paid him. And so he directed us where the mayor's office was. This is City Hall in Atlanta, Georgia.
First hallway. see it. There's any over there. Well, yeah,
I'd
like
to. Yeah,
how's
that?
How you doing?
Oh, perfect.
Thank you.
Plus that job is so tired.
Hello.
Good morning. We
just a moment, okay?
I've been on a mission for 4 years getting a picture. Recently, in the last month, we sent the mail a certified letter about my issue. No one seemed to respond. And this guy is with the press, and we're trying to get the ball over. I'd like to speak to someone in the mail office about the mission, James Rutledge. They have all the information about my case. June.
Yeah, it was in June.
But I've been on this task for 4 years. They showed me the front side of the check. I worked for the city of Atlanta from 1988 to 1990. When I applied for the picture, applied. On the application, they had to send a copy of my birth certificate to apply. But when I allegedly, which I never received any money, allegedly, when I received these two checks, they only gave me a copy of the front side. That's for the back side where I signed it and it went through the bank. So I've been in pursuit of that information for 4 years.
How are you?
I have not received any money.
Thank you.
$0. I've been to the pigeon board meeting. I've talked to Ray Allen in the pigeon. I've talked to the commissioner Yancey. I've talked to people on the first floor of the mayor's office. So, why is it that I can't get someone to give me the money that I work for? Thank you. Then they want me to have a seat.
Sure, that's fine. Let me see. Can I see your paper, please? I just need your permission. Hi. James Rutledge. Hi. Tanisha Weaver, she handles the mail.
June 1st, wait 15 days for a response. We didn't get a response, so we called back. The lady that we talked to on the phone was the lady that received the certified mail. Mm-hmm. And she indicated, well, sir, send me another copy. Ma'am, in every department of the city of Atlanta, from the pension department, the law office.
So you don't have another copy?
Everybody has a copy. What's the purpose? Keep
so
seeing your copy.
Is it possible if we can get another? Because we get the mayor a copy.
Listen to me.
Everybody down here has a copy.
Okay, so I don't have a copy.
In 4 years.
I don't have a copy, so that's why I'm asking. If I can get a copy. But if you don't want to give me one, that's okay, sir. That's all I'm asking.
Excuse me, ma'am. What if he just give you? Can you make a copy of it?
Yes, that's no problem, sir.
Can you do that?
I don't have no problem making a copy. Okay.
Just, that lady that just...
That's, yeah. She's the assistant for COO. She has. I'm the scheduling assistant for Mayor Reed.
We got you.
So if I can get a copy, I definitely don't.
When she comes back with it, ma'am, you are more than that.
No problem. Okay.
But see, the reason that I think they just sent me through the waiting stage all over again. I've been at this for 4 years. Mm-hmm. 4 years. I waited when the commissioner was doing the budget. I waited 4 months to get an appointment.
Okay.
I went to the pension board office, talked to Ray Adams. They sent me to the law office. Then when we went to the law office, he sent it back down to the picture. Well, it just been in and out of one place to another.
Well, to make something real short, from my understanding, he called me. I'm come up from Valdosta. But if he requested that, if he just could see, don't worry about that. If he could just see the back of the checks where he signed, it won't.
Then the paper trail away with the bank.
But he can't. His signature not even on the checks they sent. I don't know why they would even send him a copy of a check.
You mean with the pension people.
Well,
no, the
checks that he supposedly cashed, his signature.
When I apply, just the application of applying for the money, I had to send them a copy of my birth certificate to apply for the money. They wanted to make sure that I was who I said I was.
Okay.
But yet, when they gave me a check of $8,000, allegedly, it should be a copy of a valid picture ID to receive the money.
Gotcha.
If it's that strict on the application, why is it so lack on the receiver? They have not gave me my money.
Well, let me go check back with the mail
since
she
has it. I'm not asking for no food stamp welfare. This is.
I think we are going to need to. Is this copy for us, or do
you need
this
to make
back?
A copy, though. That's my own personal.
Okay, so we'll make a copy of this, and we'll respond to you in writing by the end of the week. Okay?
Okay.
Okay.
What do you think about the end of the week? You believe that?
No, I don't.
You don't?
No, I don't.
Why don't you believe they're going to respond to you? This is city government.
They haven't responded in 4 years, but why have I said that they're going to respond in the end of the week? Okay? And when you get back, then they'll respond. I want a paper trail of the signature, my signature, and the paper trail that went to a bank. That when she come back, would your response include all the information? And I want you to video. I need the paper trail where I signed the check. See, I've been through this before.
I know. I realize that.
So my request in your response, will it show a paper trail where I signed the check?
I can't say that it will have the signed check. I see that they provided you a copy of this check. I don't know that they'll be able to provide the back side of this check because it was... This was from...
Well, see, I asked for this. I asked for this.
This was... I realized what
in
you...
In 97 and 98.
Yeah, this was from 1997. I don't know if they'll be able to provide that for you. I don't.
So what is your response? I've been through this.
That's
why I have requested.
Right.
I requested this 3.5 years ago.
I see that you have met with HR. That we will review this information and you will receive a response. I can't tell you what it's going to be. I haven't read any of the information you provided.
And your response.
I'm sorry?
In all that you're doing now.
Uh-huh.
I'm requesting that I can speak to America Team Reed.
Okay. They'll respond and let you know whether or not you can have an appointment.
No, it's not an option.
Okay.
This is money that I worked for.
Okay.
They have not gave me one dime. Not a dime.
Okay.
You say you gave me a check, but it's no signature, it's no paper trail. With all the resources that the city of Atlanta, even in 1998, have, in 4 years, they could have went to Africa and investigated, find out what happened to my money. In 4 years, with all the resources that the city of Atlanta have, in 4 years, if it was embedded over in Africa, they don't have time. My nephew, I have gave him power of attorney to pursue this matter if something ever happened to me. Somebody in my family or me is going to enjoy my pension money, my money that I work for.
Okay.
And everybody tell me to be patient. Like, say, now wait a minute, then I don't hear no response from you. I don't believe it's going to be a response. Okay, I talked to Councilman Martin. He said, in 4 years, right here, you got a lawyer. I live off a fixed income. I don't have $2,500 to give a lawyer for a retainer fee. That's 3 months of my Social Security check. I don't have that kind of money. And I shouldn't even have to go through this to get my money. Simple. It's just simple, ABC.
You know, another thing, he called me up here. I was up here 3 weeks ago. I came up here from Valon 3 weeks ago, and we talked to a lady that said she was the secretary of the mayor. And we haven't even received a courteous reply from a city government in the state of Georgia and in the U.S.
Do you know who you spoke to?
Yeah, we have a document. We definitely have it. We document everything.
Do you just have the person's name?
Well, did you write it down there, or did we put it in that tablet?
I think so. It's in this information on the first page, the lady that received the certified letter. I hope y'all don't have to go through what I'm going through.
Receive the certified letter from the mayor?
Call me?
Receive this letter from the mayor?
Yes.
That was me.
Okay. But then you asked me to send another copy.
Right, and I never received another
but
copy.
But see, I mean, what's...
And you, a whole month I didn't get a copy from you, sir. If I
a whole month? I've been waiting for 4 years. Every department, I sent you a copy.
I'm sorry. And
you was the one that told me that you received the copy.
On June 2nd, correct.
So why you need another copy when you already got
the copy? Mayor got the copy. The original. I didn't make a copy from myself.
Make five.
I have a copy now, sir.
Make another one. So when I come back.
We have the copies. We are going to review what you've submitted, and you will have a response from our office within the week and a response to your request for a meeting with the mayor. Okay?
Yes, ma'am. Thank you, God bless.
Okay. Thank you all very much.
I apologize.
It's okay.
But you don't know how frustrated I am. 4 years.
I understand.
I couldn't even apply for the money in 98. You have to be 55. Even the lawyer from the pension board told me, sir, I don't see how they sent you a check in 98. Even if I had applied in 98, I would have been denied based on the age requirement.
Okay.
You have to be 55. I was 45. I simply changed job. I got a better job at the DeKalb County Sheriff's Department, and I changed job. That's all I did.
Well, you'll have a response.
Okay. Okay. Thank you, God bless. Excuse me, ma'am. Is it
the thank you for your professionalism. Thank you so much, man. Really do. Thank you.
Where can people? You get a check for $8,000.
Okay, after doing that walk, what do you think? Do you feel any more confident, or how do you feel about your situation now?
Well, sir, I feel confident when they give me my money. Because really, for me, I've been through this for 4 years. I was excited 3 years ago when I talked to the commissioner Yancey about my case. But being excited and not getting no money, so I'm not excited. I'd be excited when they give me my money.
Do you feel like when she said that you'll get a response, you think that'd just be a general response, but you won't get
it? It's just gonna be a general response. That's why I specified what I want in your response for the paper trail, the signature of the check that I received. Because see, to me, it's just like, here we go again. Here we go again.
So being a government entity, you believe that if they actually provided you with a check, that there should be a paper trail somewhere to show that you actually signed for that check, and you know for a fact that you did not sign for the check. Am I correct?
I never see it.
Okay.
I never see it.
Why do you think it's so hard for, from looking at the employees, it seems as if though they seem a little concerned about whether you actually signed for the check or not?
Well, I cannot read and say why a person doing this.
Right. I noticed you're very cautious on that.
I can't say why. Right. I don't know why. All I can say is that they're sticking together. They're sticking together. From the law department, the pension department, the commissioner Yancey department, everybody is saying that they believe my story. Like, that's the impression that I got from them. That they believe my story. But then investigate and find out what happened to my money. With the resources that the city of Atlanta has, if I had a way to Jamaica, Russia, they have the resources to find out where the money was.
And you brought up also, I think you showed some type of documentation that there was something that has been reported in terms of money being misappropriated.
Yes, the SEC, the Securities Exchange Commission Office out of Washington, D.C., allegedly said that even she said that was in 2013, that the pension director in Belgium, $1.2 million. See,
from me doing this since 1975 in terms of on social media, it seems to me that there should be somebody or some agencies that can actually account for the taxpayers' dollars as well as other complaints that may have been registered with the city of Atlanta about other people, workers, not getting their pension.
If the allegedly part was $1.2 million, there has to be a bunch of money. That's a lot of money.
Well, a lot of people probably gave up. Why haven't you given up?
Because I'm not asking for a handout. I'm not asking for a handout.
Okay.
I'm asking for the money that I labeled for 10 years. No, it's not ours. No, it's not ours.
Okay. All right. Thank you very much. One closing remark I'd like to get from you. Why did you call to get to Free Press to get this in the news?
Because I've been going through a revolving door from one department to the other department. Wait 3 months and no response. Then it's starting all over. It's been 4 years. My intention is if the media get involved, then I get some type of result.
Well, we are going to, I do have some contact with some people in Washington, D.C. I doubt they will be able to help, but we will be sending it to some agency that I've sent other stuff, information and videos to, okay?
This step that we're doing now is more encouraging than anything, because I feel like if the media get involved, then they have to respond.
No, they do not.
But it often works better than not having it, but I have worked
cases with Equipment 10 plus 2 with the newly elected black mayors in 16, 18 cities, voting rights, and even the Democratic chair of DuBose Board won't even address it.
nor the Secretary of State, the Attorney General Sam Olin, they're all aware of this, but they sit back and say and do nothing. So we are hoping that under our form of government, that somebody will deal with you, because in your situation, you're talking about $14,000 during these hard economic times.
This, I just started drawing my Social Security. This money will help me get me a place to stay. I stay with someone. I don't have my own place. You know, the government, you can't live off of $844. You can't. This money would help me achieve that goal.
Okay, once again, what's your name and a phone number?
James Rutledge. Phone number 678-760-0725.
Thank you very much. There's a great possibility that maybe some news media here in Atlanta will care enough about your situation to focus in on it. I'm down in Valdosta. I don't mind putting it out there. But I believe that there should be Atlanta Journal-Constitution. Somebody should address your issues. Because after all, there may be a lot of other people with the same problems, but they just gave up because nobody would cover their story.
Well, P.S., they respond. I did get in contact with Claude Howard 2 years ago.
Okay.
One of his assistants said that if the two or three people that they can't involve with just my single issue.
Yes, sir.
But if it's three or four different people having the same problem that I'm having, then it's a problem.
Okay. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Have you gone to the Atlanta Journal and Constitution or Clark Howard or anybody else in Atlanta, WAOK radio station, anybody to get your story told? Because there just may be other former employees for the city of Atlanta that still haven't received their money that they have rightfully earned, but it seems as if those black city government will not pay y'all. So you think there may be others in the same predicament?
Question.